sir, as far as I know, you're a person from UAE, right? You reside in UAE.
Yeah.
So just like what you mentioned earlier, and now one of the major challenges which we have, which the filmmakers are having, is to get people to the place, the location where the shooting is actually happening. So do you really think that artists who are actually located outside India would face a challenge when it comes to this particular situation, wherein they might, there are chances that they might lose a chance to do a very important role?
Right now, see, there are people like me, but I think, I mean, I don't want to, you know, it's not a statement or a judgment, but I don't think there are many who are, you know, outside the country. But for people like me who are outside the country, yes, definitely we will sort of face a difficulty in, you know, getting back to regular shooting and all that. But one thing I want to add is that right now I'm in India and I'm in quarantine now because I have taken a repatriation flight with my family and I'm here in Chennai. I have a project starting next month in Kochi, actually, but which is not very official, but it is slowly in the pre-production stage. So I wanted to finish my quarantine and finish all my formalities and make sure that I abide by the law before I start working under the pandemic protocol. So, I think we should take quite a few risks from our side by providing, you know, you are abiding, you know, the law, and, you know, you are going by the protocol that is by the government. So, for people who are outside the country, outside the place where actually the trade is happening, the shoot is happening, there's going to be a bit of difficulty. But I think there's always a way out, right?
Yes, sir. As you know, we are actually streaming live in Facebook also. So there are a lot of questions coming in for you to answer.
I think people are very excited to see him.
Exactly. So many of those questions, a lot of them are actually about the treadmill dance, which we will not ask because the topic is mainly on what we are discussing right now. So one of those questions which I felt quite interesting is, as the audience are now more exposed to the international cinema, do you think our actors should also change to cater to the international market? That is a question by Nina.
Okay. Hi, Ms. Nina. I think, yes, definitely we should. I think cinema is like a global language, a global medium. And I think if you have a flair towards being approachable by many other industries apart from just your own, your own industry, which is your own country, yes, obviously you can cater to, all of them. You can approach them. And I believe in being actually in the kind of thought that you laid out right here. I believe in international cinema. I believe in experimenting with other languages, being multilingual and being, an internationally recognizable actor. It's always nice.
We have another question. Now, this is from Mr. Sunny. He wants to know about the impact or the effects of the pandemic on the actors' remuneration. Are there any impacts on, you know, the release of payment, stuff like that for the actors?
Yes, I would say it is one of the side effects of, you know, what happens, during this pandemic. And I would say even if the remuneration is cut or there is a compromise in the remuneration, likewise with other technicians and all the other rest of the crew and the unit. I think everything is because of, I think we should understand the practically faced problems, because at the end of the day, the unit's boss, who's the producer, has to also meet his own challenges and the expenses, and he or she has a budget of, you know, on what based on what you're taking the film on. So I think we should be flexible. At the same time, I think there are always lines that you need to follow, which should be mutually followed, is what I must say. It should not be one-sided, for the good of everybody on both the sides. For the people paying and for the people who are being paid, I think it should be justifiable. And I think as far as there is work, we are more than happy. Work is something that we need at this time. Right? Like I said, we have heard of Indian Idol, IDOL. Now we are Indian Idols, IDLE. So We should, I think we just start working again. And the very fact that we are entertainers and we are catering such a special, you know, craft, because I think the entertainment industry is a very, very big priority. Nothing more than the medical industry or any other industry who is in the front line of serving to the public. But at the end of the day, I think we do add up to quite a lot of positivity and quite a lot of, you know, entertainment and stress relief for, you know, for the people who are going through a lot of stress. So I think, yes, it's nice to have the trade coming back, and with the theaters being shut and, you know, right now not having able to go to the public places, I think OTT is again a very big opening, which has already become the next big thing. It was the next big thing before, but it is already the big thing today, and it is one of the most demanded mediums that we can see, platforms that we can see, and it's a very big opening for creative minds, you know, alike. Like, you know, whether you're a big name, whether you're a starter, whether you're, you know, whoever you are in the industry, you know, no matter how many years of experience you have. Regardless of anything, I think OTT is a platform that welcomes everyone. As far as you have content, you know, it's going to be a winner. So content has always been the winner, whether it is theater or any other platform. So I believe that films not releasing in theaters is not going to be a factor in which a film is a winner or a loser, or a neutral film, a neutral success. But I think a good film will always win, no matter whatever platform it is.
So I have a next question, which I will have to present in a little decorative manner. As far as I know, Mr. Ashwin, he's an actor. Mm-hmm. He's an excellent dancer, and he performs mimicry in a very professional manner also. Okay. A versatile, a multi-talented actor. So this question was actually referring to that. Like, we have already seen your acting skills through the movies which you have acted. We have already seen the treadmill dance. Now, is there something else coming from the next, the different talents that you possess? Is a question from Dilsha.
Yeah, I mean, I think I've already started that. I mean, there's nothing that, you know, I plan and do. I do something literally from the bottom of my heart, through thorough passion, love for what I do. And I will keep doing stuff.
Yes, sir.
That actually brings out his versatility.
Exactly. So just like what we were saying, the questions have been coming in and we were taking the questions even between the session so that we can give them immediate responses and the people are getting engaged about the things that are happening. Ashwin sir, thank you very much for this particular time that we had with you. And we got a very detailed kind of an expression.
Insight into the life of an actor. What is it that you're going through, you know, as your entire fraternity? The, you know, what is it that you are experiencing right now, and probably what is it that you are going to plan for the future?
Exactly. So thank you very much once again, sir,
for joining us. We appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's been my pleasure. And I just want to tell something to all the viewers, and I'm sure there might be many people who would be aspiring to come into the industry. I just want to tell them all that there is always light at the end of the tunnel. There is nothing that you need to slouch and be dejected, feel dejected, feel demotivated. I think all of us are really special in our own way, and things will obviously become better. And at the end of the day, I think we have to start accepting reality as it is and go with the flow. Thank you.
So, sir, thank you so much. Wish you all the very best for the upcoming projects, and we are very eager to see you on screen back again.
I want to thank Garden City University again. I've always been a close associate with Garden City University, and I just want to, you know, thank Garden City University management, and also my love to all the students of Garden City University. Thank you so much.